Using money seized under proceeds of crime legislation, the Scottish Government's Sports Facilities Fund was created in 2011 to award funding to local authority community payback services. A successful bid to this fund saw six key sports facilities projects across South Lanarkshire win backing to be put into action. South Lanarkshire's community payback team have worked with the management committee of Whitlaburn's Bonus Ball Centre to provide a new outdoor multi-use games area, which features an all-weather playing surface and multi-sport markings. An outdoor exercise circuit has been created, providing durable exercise equipment suitable for people from aged 15 and up. A perimeter fence was erected around the exercise area. Inside the bonus ball, the main hall, reception area, cafe, smaller hall and interior corridors have been deep cleaned and painted. The floor of the main hall was completely refreshed and then remarked for sports including tennis and basketball. New curtains and blinds were supplied and fitted. BMX is now a popular and well-established sport, and the purpose-built tracks at Overton Park in Rutherglen and Crawford Dyke and Carluke are well used by local young people. Use and weathering had left both tracks in need of attention. In Rutherglen, Community Payback worked alongside the Friends of Overton Park group and the South Lanarkshire Youth Trust RegenFX to redesign the track to ensure it provided a facility that could be used by all BMX enthusiasts from beginners to experts. Along with general improvements to the track conditions, new sections and jumps were added. At Crawford Dyke and Carluke, the track received similar care to both renovate and upgrade it. Both facilities will now continue to provide young people with a meeting place and focus where they can have fun and get involved in healthy exercise. In doing so, the tracks make a genuine contribution to reducing nuisance and antisocial behaviour. Community Payback worked alongside the Community Planning Partnership's Tackling Poverty programme in Burnhill to see where the greatest contribution could be made. Preparing the way for the equipment and track meant extensive clearing of fly tipping, cutting back of overgrown trees and shrubs, and preparing the ground. The improvements and addition of equipment will provide a focus for healthy activity and tackle hotspots for antisocial behaviour. The sensory garden at the back of the centre was given a makeover, which included overhauling the raised beds, clearing and weeding paths, and a general tidy up. Inside the centre, the sports hall was given a clean and repaint, and the floor was updated with a state-of-the-art cushioned covering as used in the Olympics. The kitchen area was given a complete makeover with new units and worktops and painting. The neighbouring meeting room was repainted and re-carpeted. Working with grassroots boxing clubs, the team drove forward the total renovation of two gyms, one in Lark Hall and one in Westburn. The improvements have created a fresher, more welcoming environment that's already seen an increase in membership and activity.
We've had a lot of new members join the club because it's a bit more attractive to them now, and the numbers have actually gone up considerably. I've got young kids from the age of 7 and right up to the age of 50. There's a lot of rivalry between gangs in the local community in different areas, and that breaks down a lot of barriers when the kids know each other from the boxing club. It makes it a bit safer for them to get into other areas, and it also gets them off the street and keeps them out of trouble.
Community Payback teams were already involved in regular maintenance work on the Clyde walkway. The proceeds of crime funding allowed some much-needed repair and replace work on sections of the path that had fallen into disrepair, and included new fencing, a major section of boardwalk, and even relaying a stretch of track more than half a kilometre long.
There are many benefits that we found using them. I mean, not only do we get work done in our network of access paths and the wider environment, but it provides the participants with an opportunity to learn new skills and experiences that they can maybe use later on in life.
It's been a very, very positive relationship between supported employment at David Livingstone Centre and Community Payback. The additional labour that it's brought onto the site has enabled us to carry out the request for works that we would have been unable to do and unable to achieve without the additional support from Community Payback. It's been a very rewarding experience for us all. it's not only about the labour on site, it's us about working together to make an inclusive partnership.